This is Black Swan and Australian Roses. The reason it's called that, it was a shading ink that I saw used, and it was a vintage style ink, and it would have deeper lines on the sides where the tines of a flex nib touch the page, and the center would be lighter. This was done with a knife, and where the blade pressed against the page is darker and lighter here. The effect on a paper towel, the Black Swan in essence, is that what you see, that you see in the middle, and the rose garden is surrounding it. And this effect, it comes out with flex nibs, it comes out with some italic nibs, and that's what I was aiming for with this ink. It's about 16% bulletproof permanent, but it's the combination of the dyes that make this ink what it is. The label artwork, this is the original portrait. The Australian Black Swan, a catfish with a spatula and a fork and a tear coming out of his eye. Because he's looking at this swan, and the swan doesn't know whether he wants to eat him. Well, he probably does want to eat the swan. Large catfish in Texas and Oklahoma, if one of them's in a pond or a tank, as they call it down there, they'll eat migrating waterfowl, and they'll get to a magnificent size. And that'll be all they have to eat, because they've eaten all of the fish in the lake or pond, and there's nothing left except migrating waterfowl. On the label, it says, from the catfish, "No fears, mate, I am not Zeus, and I only eat yabbies." That's his attempt at convincing the swan to come in and have dinner with him. It's an Australian phrase, and it references yabbies, which are the blue freshwater crayfish or lobster. They're quite large, that live in Australia. And unlike the American crayfish, they tend to have smooth shells. And it's a very Australian term and reference specific. That's would be perfectly unique for a catfish. And he's telling him that he's not Zeus either, because the Black Swan might think he's godlike after all he's speaking. And in the background here, you have Leda and the swan. And he's trying to convince the Black Swan, well, I'm not this god that's in the White Swan and is seducing Leda. And you can see that little detail in the label. And that's the background to the artwork. The tear is a little difficult to see in the label. And Leda and the swan are very small in the background of the label on purpose, because Leda does not have any clothes. And you never know who might pick up one of these bottles. The Black Swan's very specific to Australia. There's a second edition of this ink that is English roses, but it hasn't been shipped yet. And the first one of these shading inks, flex nib specific inks, is Black Swan and Australian Roses. And this is a clear NOODLER'S piston filler pen fitted with a flex nib. If you ever flex these out to 2 millimeters, do so slowly, because the feed has to catch up with the demand for the ink. But if you flex them out to 1, 1.5 millimeters, they do okay. Just at an average writing speed. It's almost like writing with a metallic brush. I get a kick out of them. I think they're quite enjoyable, and I hope to be able to make more of these available soon. It's about time a flex nib is affordable instead of costing the world. And that's the newest ink and its original artwork. Hope you enjoy it.